So we can also learn a lot about the internet by measuring our latency to different destinations. And in fact, we can also see the hops along the way. So I showed you on the map of Greece the hops along the way. We can see the same thing for destinations on the internet. And we can do that using an application called Traceroute. If you're using a Mac, you can just create a shell and run Traceroute directly. If you're using some other operating system, you might need to do something a little different, and we'll have directions for that on the site. But you can do Traceroute, and after Traceroute, you pick where you want the destination to be. So first we'll try tracing the route to udacity.com. And what Traceroute is doing is sending packets over the internet, looking at all the intermediate hops to figure out the route it takes to get a packet from where I am now to the udacity.com site. And when we run that, we see the route. You can see each hop. So from where I am now to reach udacity.com took 15 steps. The total time was about 39 milliseconds. So you can see there are several different times it's doing multiple tests, and the time might vary each test, but the time is about 39 milliseconds. And you can also see the steps. The first thing you see is that our site's actually being served on a server run by Google. So that's what the udacity.com site resolves to. And you can see all the hops along the way. The 192.168.1.1, that's a special internet address that means your local machine. You always start there. And then you can see all the other hops that we go through and the time it took to get there. And so there are different hops that took different amounts of time. You can see the time does vary. So we can see that the time to get to the Comcast site here in Santa Clara varied from 11 to 37 milliseconds. And you can see all the other hops along the way, that each hop took a millisecond or two between that hop. To get 15 hops took us about 40 milliseconds. So if we try to go somewhere further away, let's try tracing the route to mit.edu. Well, that server's running from Boston, so I'm here in California. To get to udacity.com, we didn't have to go very far geographically. To get to MIT, we've got to go across the country. So now we're going to Boston. So we started where we are now. We went through Santa Clara, went through San Jose. Sometimes from the host names, you can guess where they are. Sometimes you can't. But here it's pretty clear we're going from San Jose, and then we're going across the country to New York. And you can see that the big time difference was when we went from San Jose to New York. There's no hops. So unlike the Greeks, where the distance between hops was very limited, in the internet, the distance between hops can be thousands of miles. There's some fiber optic cable probably between those two points, and there's no need for any routing directions. Once you got to this point in San Jose, you end up in New York without going through any other decision points. And then we get to Boston, and it takes about 100 milliseconds before we get to MIT. And you can see we're not actually getting the final destination. We're getting some stars. We're not getting a response from the web server at MIT. We could do that if we tried a few more trace routes and set the timeouts differently, but to get across the country, it took about 100 milliseconds. And we can go somewhere further away. About the furthest away you can get from where I am now is Madagascar. So I'm going to try tracing a route to a server in Madagascar. If there are any students in Madagascar, please contact me. And we try that trace route, and we can see that it starts again going through San Jose, goes through Dallas. Now it's going through a lot of servers run by the same country, and that's getting across the ocean, getting towards Madagascar. And you can see it's starting to take quite a long time. So it took 100 milliseconds to get to MIT. Here we have taking 195 milliseconds already, and we haven't yet reached Madagascar. The time it takes to do the trace route is much longer than the time it takes to get a request from these pages, because it's sending many requests trying to find all the points along the way. But this is a good way you can see what's going on in the internet and get a better understanding of how packets are getting from where you are to where you're making a request.